Hello friends, this is question series for UPSC prelims 2019, so let's get started. This is about me. This is part 8. We have completed till part 7. Do watch them. Okay, question number 111. Consider the following statements about Mahila Police Volunteers, MPVs. It is a joint initiative with the Union Ministry of Home Affairs and Union Ministry of Women and Child Development. Yeah, this is correct. Kerala is the first state to adopt the initiative. This is wrong. So automatically if 2 gets eliminated, answer will be A, 1 and 3 only. So answer is A. Okay, and third statement is one Mahila Police Volunteer is envisaged per Gram Panchayat across the country. So 1 and 3 are correct. So answer is A. Originally conceived by Union Ministry of Women and Child Development, Mahila Police Volunteer is a joint initiative with the Union Ministry of Home Affairs. The Mahila Police Volunteers scheme envisages creation of a link between the police authorities and the local communities in villages through police volunteers who will be women specially trained for this purpose. Their primary job will be to keep an eye on situations where women in the village are harassed or their rights and entitlements are denied or their development is prevented. And Kerala is not the first state, Haryana is the first state. Okay, so moving on. Question 112. Consider the following statements about International Rice Research Institute. Okay, IRRI is known for its work in developing rice varieties that contributed to the Green Revolution in the 1960s. Yeah, this is correct. It aims to reduce poverty and hunger, improve the health of rice farmers and consumers. This is also correct. It is the largest non-profit agricultural research center in Asia. Yeah, this is correct. Recently, the 6th International Rice Research Institute South Asia Regional Center was dedicated to the nation. Even this is correct. So answer is D. All are correct. 1, 2, 3, 4, all are correct. So the Prime Minister dedicated the 6th International Rice Research Institute South Asia Regional Center to the nation and where it is built in Varanasi, Uttar Pradesh. The IRRI is an international agricultural research and training organization known for its work in developing rice varieties that contributed to the Green Revolution in 1960. So moving on, question 113. Consider the following statements about UN Red and Red Plus. Okay, UN Red, sorry for this spelling mistake, this is Red. UN Red is a climate change mitigation solution being developed by parties to the UNFCCC. Okay, Red Plus assist countries to keep their forests standing by offering results based payments for actions to reduce or remove forest carbon emissions. Okay, which of the above statements are incorrect? So here it is asking incorrect. So both are incorrect. So answer is C, both. Okay, so answer here is C. So you can see in this picture that it actually the statements are reversed. Okay, Red Plus is a climate change mitigation solution being developed by parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Red Plus incentivizes developing countries to keep their forest standing by offering result-based payments for actions to reduce or remove forest carbon emission. Okay, the UN Red program assists countries to develop the capacities needed to meet the UNFCCC's Red Plus requirements so that they can quantify to receive result based payments under the convention. Okay, so both these statements are reversed. Okay, moving on. Question 114. Ross Island, Neal Island and Havelock Island are located in. Okay, Lakshadweep, no. Maldives, no. Indonesia, no. Andaman and Nicobar, no. Yeah, this is correct. Sorry. Answer is D, Andaman and Nicobar. So answer is D. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi on December 30th announced renaming of 3 islands of Andaman and Nicobar Archipelago as a tribute to Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Okay. The Rose Island was renamed as Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose Dweep. The Neal Island as Shaheed Dweep and the Havelock Island as Swaraj Dweep. Okay. So for remembering it, I have done it like this, that here is Rose. So Rose is related to Bose. Here Neal is there. So Neal is having E and I. So Neal is related to Shaheed and Havelock is related to Swaraj. So I have remembered it like this. And one more important information, that all these 3 islands are part of South Andaman. So you can see here in this picture that you can see here, this is Havelock Island here, and very small here it is Ross Island, and here is Neal Island. Okay, so moving on, all are part of South Andaman. Okay, moving on, Question 115. Consider the following statements about Mobilize Your City program. Okay, the MYC aims to reduce greenhouse gas emissions related to urban transport. Yeah, this is correct. India and France have signed an implementation agreement on Mobilize Your City. Even this is correct. It was launched at 24th Conference of Parties COP24 meeting in Katowice, Poland. This is wrong. So answer here is B, 1 and 2 only. Okay, so answer is B. Mobilize Your City was launched at 21st COP. Okay, COP21 meeting in December 2015. India and France have signed an implementation agreement on Mobilize Your City. The MYC aims to reduce the greenhouse gas emission related to urban transport by implementing urban mobility plans at local level and to help India at national level to improve their sustainable transport policy. Moving on, question 116. Consider the following statements about monuments of national importance. Okay, New Delhi has the highest number of monuments of national importance in the list. Okay, in India, any structure, sculpture, inscription, etc., which is in existence for not less than 100 years is termed as ancient. Okay, which of the above statements is are correct? So here only second statement is correct. So answer is B, 2 only. So answer is B. The Archaeological Survey of India recently declared that it has added 6 structures to the list of monuments of national importance, taking the total number to 3,693. With 506 monuments under its belt, Karnataka continues to top the list in South India, followed by Tamil Nadu. Nationally too, Karnataka is in the second place after Uttar Pradesh. So Uttar Pradesh has the highest number of monuments. Okay, so in the comment section below, you can tell the Archaeological Survey of India works under which ministry. Okay, moving on. Question 117. Consider the following statements. The Speaker of Lok Sabha can suspend the members of the House for disrupting the proceedings of the House. Yeah, this is correct. The Speaker can also revoke the suspension if she desires. No, this is wrong. In case of Rajya Sabha, the chairman has the power to suspend the member. Even this is wrong. So we have to find out correct statement. So one only. Okay. So first statement is correct. So answer is A, one only. So answer is A. Among the tools available to the Speaker for ensuring discipline is the power to force a member to withdraw from the House for the remaining part of the day or to place him under suspension. While the Speaker is empowered to place a member under suspension, the authority for revocation of this order is not vested in her. Okay, the Speaker can suspend, but it cannot revoke that suspension. Okay, it is for the House, if it so desires, to resolve on a motion to revoke the suspension. Unlike the Speaker, the Rajya Sabha chairman does not have the power to suspend a member. So Rajya Sabha chairman is the Vice President of India, so he does not have the power to suspend a member. In such a situation, the House may adopt a motion suspending the member from the service of the House for a period not exceeding the remainder of the session. The House may, however, by another motion terminate the suspension. So moving on, question 118. According to Citizenship Act 1955, an illegal immigrant is defined as a person. So this Citizenship Act is so much in news, you can definitely expect a question in your prelims exam. Okay, who enters India without a valid passport? Yeah, this is correct. Stays in the country after the expiry of the visa permit. Even this is correct. The immigrant who use false documents for the immigration process. Even this is correct. So answer is D, all of them. So according to Citizenship Act 1955, an illegal immigrant is defined as a person who enters India without a valid passport or stays in the country after the expiry of the visa permit. Also, the immigrant who uses false documents for the immigration process. So moving on, question 119. Consider the following statements about National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission. Okay, NCDRC is a quasi-judicial commission in India. This is correct. It is a non-statutory body. No, this is wrong. The commission is headed by a sitting or retired judge of the Supreme Court of India. Even this is correct. So answer is A, 1 and 3 only. So answer is A. The National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission, India is a judicial, quasi-judicial commission in India, which was set up in 1988 under the Consumer Protection Act of 1986. Its head office is in New Delhi. The commission is headed by a sitting or retired judge of the Supreme Court of India. Moving on, question 120. Consider the following statements about Bharatmala Pariyojana. Bharatmala project is the largest highway construction project in the country. Okay, it includes development of economic corridors, inter corridors, and feeder routes National Corridor Efficiency Improvement, Border and International Connectivity Roads, Coastal and Port Connectivity Roads, and Greenfield Expressway. Okay. One of the shortfall is the missing focus on connectivity in Northeast. Which of the above statements is are incorrect? So answer here is A, 1 and 3 only, because second one is correct. So answer is A, 1 and 3. Bharatmala project is the second largest, not the largest, second largest highways construction project in the country since NHDP, under which almost 50,000 kilometer or highway roads were targeted across the country. Okay, so you can read the rest of the description. Moving on, question 121. Consider the following statements about Staff Selection Commission. Okay, Staff Selection Commission is a statutory body. Okay, it is an attached body under Department of Personnel and Training. Okay, which of the above statements is are correct? So first is wrong, second is correct. So answer is B, 2 only. So answer is B. A parliamentary standing committee has recommended that the center accord statutory status to the Staff Selection Commission, one of the largest recruitment agencies in the country. The SSC was created to ease the burden of the UPSC by taking over the recruitment for post below the Group A level. It has remained an attached body under the Department of Personnel and Training and has to depend entirely on the government for all its needs with no autonomy. So moving on, question 122. Consider the following statements about rare disease. Okay, rare disease is the one which occurs rarely during extreme weather condition. Okay, most rare diseases are genetic. Okay, the most common rare diseases recorded in India are lysosomal storage disorders such as Pompe disease, Hirschsprung disease and Gaucher's disease. Okay, so which of the above statements is are correct? So answer is C, 2 and 3 only. First is wrong. So answer is C. A rare disease, also referred to as an orphan disease, is any disease that affects a small percentage of the population. Most rare diseases are genetic and are present throughout a person's entire life, even if symptoms do not immediately appear. So moving on, question 123. Consider the following statements about Fugitive Economic Offenders Law. Okay, a person can be named a fugitive economic offender for involvement in the economic offenses involving at least rupees 50 crore or more. Okay, till now more than 10 persons have been declared a fugitive economic offender under the Fugitive Economic Offenders Act. Okay, the investigating agencies have to file an application in a special court under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002 for confiscation of properties of the order. Okay, which of the above statements is are correct? So see guys, second statement easily you can eliminate, because it is saying that till now 10 persons have been declared. This law is very very new. Okay, recently it has been recently this became law, and how can so quickly 10 person can be declared under this law? So if you eliminate second by some logic, easily you are left with only one option, that is B. So answer here is B, only 3. So answer is B. Vijay Mallya has become the first person to be declared a fugitive economic offender under the Fugitive Economic Offenders Act. A person can be named an offender under this law if there is an arrest warrant against him or her for involvement in an economic offense involving at least rupees 100 crore or more, not 50 crore, and has fled from India to escape legal action. Okay. So moving on, question 124. The India Meteorological Department, IMD, issues cyclone alert during, okay, issued 72 hours in advance with early warning about the development of a cyclonic disturbance. No, this is wrong. Issued at least 48 hours in advance of the expected commencement of adverse weather over the coastal areas. Yeah, this is correct. So answer here is B. So answer is B. The cyclone warnings are issued to state government officials in four stages. Okay, first stage is of pre-cyclone watch. Okay, when cyclone is there are early warnings about the development of a cyclonic disturbance, so that is known as pre-cyclone watch. Okay, and it is issued 72 hours in advance. Then second alert is of cyclone alert. Okay, so in advance of the expected commencement of adverse weather over coastal area, so it is issued at least 48 hours in advance. Then third stage warning is cyclone warning, and it is issued at least 24 hours in advance. And fourth stage is post landfall outlook, that is at least 12 hours in advance of expected time of landfall. So moving on, question 125. Ease of doing business index on attractiveness to investors, business friendliness and competitive policies is released by. So many of you might be thinking that it is released by World Bank. This is wrong. So answer here is D, Asia Competitiveness Institute. So answer is D. Asia Competitiveness Institute has released its Ease of Doing Business Index on Attractiveness to Investor, Business Friendliness and Competitive Policies. Performance of Indian States, Andhra Pradesh has topped the list and it is followed by Maharashtra and Delhi. So moving on, question 126. The South Asian Enigma, a term sometimes seen in the news, refers to the paradox of having recently experienced fast economic growth and it is without translation into improved nutrition. So answer is A. So answer here is A. Despite India's fast economic growth and poverty reduction over the past few decades, food insecurity remains very high. This puzzle has been named the South Asian Enigma. Some indicators of food insecurity, especially child undernourishment rates, are now worse in India than in Ethiopia. Okay. This is despite the fact that Ethiopia has only a quarter of India's per capita income and has suffered many famines in the 20th century. So we have become worse than Ethiopia, okay, in terms of child undernourishment. This is a very sad thing. Moving on, question 127. Consider the following pairs, okay. On one side you have rover, spacecraft or lander, and on the other side you have associated space agency and asteroid or comet which it will land on. Okay, so first is OSIRIS-REx, European Space Agency and BennU. This is wrong. MASCOT, German Aerospace Center and Ryugu. This is correct. Rosetta, Roscosmos and 67P Churyumov, Gerasimenko. Even this is wrong. So answer here is C, 3 only. So answer is C. Sorry friends, answer is B. As I said, that second one is correct. So answer is B, 2 only. So answer is B. OSIRIS-REx is a mission of NASA and it will go for asteroid BennU. Okay, and MASCOT is of DLR German and CNES French Space Agency and it will go for Ryugu, and Rosetta is of European Space Agency. Okay, so moving on, question 128. Gillette Jones is a term recently seen in the news, are associated with protest across. Okay, so answer is D, France. So it is associated with France. So answer is D. So in mid-November, more than 280,000 people dressed in high visibility jackets blocked roads across France in protest at rising tax on diesel and petrol, which the government says are to fund eco-friendly projects and reduce greenhouse gas emission. A small number of hardcore protesters have continued blocking roads and petrol stations since then. Gillette Jones is French for yellow vest. Okay, so you can see in this picture that these people are wearing yellow color jacket. Okay, so the translation for yellow vest for French is Gillette Jones. Okay, so that is it. Moving on, question number 129. Consider the following statements. To reduce the likelihood of dioxin and furan formation, refuse-derived fuel must be burnt at high temperatures more than 1000 degrees Celsius. Yeah, this is correct. About 80% of the total plastic waste generated in a year in India is not recycled. So even this is correct. So answer is C, both. So answer is C. Burning plastic for fuel should be the last option. When plastic is burnt, industries must extract fossil fuel again to make new plastic. By burning it, you are destroying it, which means you mine for new material. Okay. This increases the carbon footprint for the product. Secondly, burning plastic without emission is tough. In cement kilns, for example, RDF must be incinerated at more than 1000 degrees Celsius to prevent the release of pollutants such as dioxins and furans. So moving on, last question for the day, question 130. The Food Sustainability Index ranks 67 countries on food system sustainability. This index has been developed by World Economic Forum, no, IFPRI, International Food Policy and Research Institute, no, Barilla Center for Food and Nutrition. Yeah, this is correct. So answer here is C. So answer is C. The Food Sustainability Index, FSI, developed by the Economist Intelligence Unit with Barilla Center for Food and Nutrition, ranks 67 countries on food system sustainability. It is a quantitative and qualitative benchmarking model that measures the sustainability of food systems across three categories: food loss and waste, sustainable agriculture, and nutritional challenges. The index has three key types of performance indicators: environmental, social and economic. So that is it for this lecture. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Do share this video with your friends so that they can also get benefited. Thanks for watching. All the best. Good night.